I'm Carlos Fernández Álvarez. I'm the senior coal analyst in the International Energy Agency in Paris. I think the future of coal will be determined by how coal can compete in the power generation. So, in order to summarize, if coal is able to provide the electricity in an environmental friendly way, meaning low emissions of air pollutant, that is, this is a technology already existing, in a flexible way, in order to accommodate increasing variable renewables, and with a low carbon, a future of coal will be great. But we have technologies for the air pollutant flexibility. We have technology to make plants flexible, but the CO2 challenge remains. Carbon capture has a problem of public perception, because let's say that from a green or 100% green perspective is a way to subsidize, let's say, fossil fuels. And since very recently, for the fossil fuel industry, was a burden. So there was not a place. And when we the IEA, we are for many years emphasizing, remarking the importance of CCS, because it's not about coal. It's not about power generation, it's about a low carbon future. So, for example, if we run numbers, 3% of the support of the renewables has gone to CCS, so 30 times less. Or if we talk on investment, 1%, less than 1% of what had been invested in renewables has been invested in CCS. So there are lots of things to do. There has been some impact. I mean, there are some views that as coal demand has rebounded the last year and this year, nothing happened. But I mean, finance coal mines is more difficult now. Finance coal power plants is very difficult. So something has changed. But it's true that it didn't change radically, you know. So, but it's true that the coal power plants under construction today will be the demand of the future. So in this sense, we have seen a slowing down of investment. So something has happened, you know, but it's true that there's no dramatic change, let's be honest. If Chinese coal power plants run today with the efficiency, average efficiency, they had in 2000, the coal power plants in China will emit 1 gigaton more of CO2. There is a difference, you know, and technology makes a difference, because I mean, one gigaton of CO2 is a lot, you know, it's 3% of the global energy rated emissions, so it's a lot, you know. So the same things, 600 gigawatts of coal power plants in China has been retrofitted, what they call ultra low emission. And again, this is avoiding millions of tons of NOx, sulfur and dust emissions, you know. So there has been a great advance, technological advance, and China has been leading. I mean, in other places like Japan or Germany, these modern coal power plants had been already established, but I think the big push for this has been China. Well, I think it's a coal transit is always a great opportunity to have a fresh, updated market, to see people and have more closer contact. So I always enjoy coal transit. It's a great opportunity if you are working on coal.